I was an adventurous eater as a kid. You know, I'm Egyptian, and so I have a Middle Eastern background, and so the food in my home was very, very flavor forward. And, you know, Middle Eastern food is heavy on everything, acid, sweet, spice, richness. You know, it's very heavy in the food. And so that kind of opened up my palate to being adventurous. Go to late night food. Well, for snacks, it's pistachios, and I'm terrible because I eat way too many of them. But as far as food, honestly, I would still say that nothing, I'm very simple. Pizza or a burger will always be the essentials for late night. Tony's Pizza in San Francisco is the spot. That's the spot. My first boss out of culinary school, or actually when I was on my intern, was George Marone. And very, very dynamic chef. I was at the Hotel Bel Air, and I learned so much from George. George is an amazing chef, very talented, but what he really taught me, I think that I've taken throughout my whole career, and I've never seen anybody that was better at it than him, is he could walk through a dining room and make every person in that dining room feel like he was there to cook for them and only them. And he was great at the table. We used to always joke because he would have a glass of wine at every table in the dining room. Somebody would pour him a glass of wine everywhere. And you know, it was true hospitality. And so, you know, I definitely, I really am gracious to him because I really feel like that was something that I would have, you know, it would have taken years to really understand how valuable that was. I started in this industry typical to a lot of chefs. A lot of times it starts out as a job, and that's what it started as for me. It started out as, you know, washing dishes and bussing tables, and then quickly you get the bug, and I got the bug within 2 or 3 months. I was 15, and I started, you know, really just every moment of free time I had that I could go to work early or stay late, I would just ask the gentleman who was running the kitchen if I could, you know, help cook. And then by the time I was, you know, 6 months into it, I was cooking full time. And at that time, it was, you know, it was just very addictive. And then the camaraderie of what happens in a kitchen. And then probably still the most magical part of being a chef is there's very few industries where you're going to get that immediate gratification. You know, you get to watch people eat your food, and you know, if you know, when people tell you that they remember this day because of this dish, it's pretty impactful. Cookbooks on my shelf right now, I would say Daniel Hum's book, and I know it's not that new, but it's a beautiful book.